Hello students, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jagdeep. In this video series, we are talking about indifference curve analysis for the advanced segment. In our previous video, we talked about PCC, which is price consumption curve for inferior goods. This video shall focus upon PCC for Giffen goods. Before we move on to deriving the PCC for Giffen goods, let's take a look at what Giffen goods are. So without wasting any time further, let's get started. So as you can see on the slide, Giffen goods are inferior goods on which a consumer is spending a greater proportion of his income. Another important thing, they are an exception to the law of demand. When I say exception, what does it mean? It indicates that with a fall in price, the quantity demanded for Giffen goods would also fall, and with a rise in price, the quantity demanded for Giffen goods would also rise. That means the price and quantity demanded of Giffen goods, they vary directly. All right. Now, before we move on to drawing the PCC curve, let's take a look at how the price effect, income effect, and substitution effect would work in case of Giffen goods. So the first thing is, first we have to identify how the income effect and substitution effect would look like in case of Giffen goods. So we are assuming that the price of Giffen goods falls. Now, when the price of Giffen goods falls, as far as the income effect is concerned, the real income of consumer would go up. Since the price of Giffen goods have fall, it is relatively cheaper. Relatively cheaper than other commodities, indicating that substitution could be done by a consumer if he is willing. But we need to remember one thing that we studied right in the beginning, that is, a consumer is spending a greater proportion of his income on these goods and services. That means, as far as the income effect is concerned, a consumer would have a higher real income. That means the income effect is much stronger than the substitution effect. Now, since a consumer has a higher real income with him now, he's feeling more richer, he would not want to buy more of these inferior goods. In fact, he would use this spare income to buy more of superior goods. Hence, the overall impact on the quantity would fall. That means the quantity demanded would go down as there is a fall in the price of Giffen goods. Let's take a look at how it would look on a graph. Now, in this graph, good X is a Giffen good. We have the budget line, which is AB, and the indifference curve IC is tangent to this budget line at point E. At point E, a consumer is purchasing X0 quantity of this Giffen good. Now, when the price of Giffen good falls, we should know where the budget line would rotate. If we don't know this, you have to watch a previous video to understand why and when and how the budget line is moving. Let's name it as AB1. Now, we've already seen that the consumer would buy less than what he was buying earlier with a fall in price of the Giffen good. That means he may not purchase as much that he was earlier. In this scenario, the consumer may land up at, let us say, IC1 with E1 as the point of intersection, and he'll be consuming X1 quantity of the Giffen good, which is lesser than before. This is how it would be represented on the indifference curve analysis scenario. So what has the overall impact been? The overall impact is quantity demanded of Giffen goods just went down when the price of Giffen goods fell. So when we join these blue pointers, we get a curve which is backward bending. Let me try and draw it as smoothly as I can. It's not very smooth, but when you draw it on your books, your answer sheets, it might look much better than what it looks here on the iPad. Anyways, this curve is a PCC curve for Giffen goods, and it has a backward bend. Alright, students, if you find my videos useful, please go ahead and share it with your friends as well. If you do not find learning through big videos comfortable, you can watch my Instagram channel as well. You could find reels on quite a lot of topics from this segment as well, and you could learn in a much shorter duration. As I've been telling in all my videos so far that I'll be releasing notes, I am almost done and prepared with the first segment of this series. I'll be releasing those notes shortly, and I'll put an update regarding that on my community page in my posts. So keep a track of the posts that I make to stay updated. I shall meet you in another video with another topic. Bye now. Take care.